So last week we have seen electromagnetic wave propagation through lossy dielectrics, and in this lecture our intention will be to see electromagnetic wave propagation in other media that we have come across in the last class, right? So means all others are special cases of whatever we learned in the last class. So with that understanding, wave propagation. So last class what we did is this much only, like we solved Maxwell's equation in lossy dielectric by solving the Maxwell equation will give you the description of how electromagnetic wave is propagating in your media. That is what we did in the last class, right? We in the last class we discussed that we will be seeing the wave propagation in free space, lossless dielectric, lossy dielectric, as well as in good conductors also. So this is what we are going to get into. In this particularly, we have seen lossy dielectric as the general case, and we derived electromagnetic wave propagation equations. We saw that while passing through a medium, electromagnetic wave will get attenuated, and it will also have phase shift. So on what all quantities it will depend. So with that we defined attenuation constant as well as the phase constant or the wave number. We got the general equations like this for that. In the last class, I made a mistake in the equation. Please note these two equations. It is just in the formula. Okay, whatever we discussed is the same, remains the same. So you can note this equation in the PPT which I will be uploading. I will change whatever I will correct whatever mistake I made. So this is alpha and beta. This tells you that your electromagnetic wave, when it is propagating in a medium, then it will get attenuated, and there will be a phase change. There will be some phase values that is represented by this beta here. So that we discussed in the last class. Now in this lecture we are getting into the special cases of that, right? The lossy dielectric is a general case. Now we will see what will happen in lossless dielectric. That is our first intention. First we will see what will happen in lossless dielectric, then we will see what happens in free space, and at last we will see what happens in good conductor. This is what we are going to cover in this lecture: electromagnetic wave propagation in lossless dielectric, free space, and good conductors. Clear? Let us get into the topic. Electromagnetic wave, let us see electromagnetic wave propagation in a lossless dielectric. That is what we will be discussing first. So in a lossless dielectric, this is the condition, what conductivity is approximately zero. That is what you mean by a lossless dielectric. There is no power loss, right? For power loss to happen, you should have some finite conductivity. So your conductivity is comparatively zero. Now apart from that, you have got your permittivity also, means it is having some definite permittivity, epsilon or epsilon zero, and mu equal to mu or mu zero, permeability also. So this two quantities are there, and one interesting part is what your conductivity is approximately zero. That is what is meant by a lossless dielectric. Because of that, this sigma by sigma will be what, somewhat very much lesser than omega epsilon. Okay, so taking that into mind, if this is the alpha and beta for a lossy dielectric, means our general case. In this condition, you can see this term sigma by omega epsilon all square. When I say my conductivity is zero, when I say my conductivity is zero, that means that what does it mean? It means that this term will be zero. So 1 plus 0 will become what? 1 plus 0 will become 1. Understood? So this term sigma by omega epsilon all square term, this will become 0, right? This sigma by omega epsilon all square will become 0. So root it will become what? Root of 1 only. Root of 1 minus 1, this whole term will become 0. So that your alpha value, since your conductivity itself is 0, since your conductivity itself is 0, what will happen? Your alpha value will be equal to 0, right? Your alpha will be equal to 0. Now if we apply this condition into our general terms here, again what? Sigma by omega epsilon on beta, if we apply, sigma by omega epsilon is 0. So 1 plus 0 is 1. Here we had minus 1, but here we have plus 1. So that what it will become? It will become the 1 plus 1 will become what? It will become 2, right? So this will become 2 here, right? So this 2 here means this whole term will become 2, and that 2 and this 2 on the denominator will become cancelled, so that you will have what? Omega is already outside and this mu epsilon is inside the root part, so your beta value will be omega root mu epsilon. You have any doubt in that, you can just apply the condition there and see. Okay, spend some time on that. So alpha value is 0 in a lossless dielectric and beta value is omega root mu epsilon, where mu is mu 0 mu r and epsilon is epsilon 0 epsilon r. Clear? Now what can you observe here? The first observation that you can have is this only, like alpha is 0 in a lossless dielectric, that is why it is lossless. Mean when your electromagnetic wave is passing and your alpha is 0 means your attenuation constant is 0, or there is no attenuation happening for the electromagnetic wave passing through a lossless dielectric, there is no attenuation happening. Clear? So that is what we can understand from this. Now apart from alpha and beta, we can calculate what the velocity of the wave, u equal to omega by beta, right? This is the general equation, u equal to omega by beta. Our beta is omega root mu epsilon, so if we apply that, we will get it as what? U equal to 1 by root mu epsilon, right? U equal to 1 by root mu epsilon, that will be the velocity of propagation of that wave in a lossless dielectric. Now last class we already also discussed intrinsic impedance, and these are the general equation for intrinsic impedance, right? These are the general equation for intrinsic impedance. It is the this is the magnitude, and this is the to find out the phase, tan 2 theta n equal to sigma by omega epsilon, right? So if we see that here, what is our condition? Our condition is that conductivity is 0, so this part have become 0, right? Once again let us see our condition is what. What is our condition? Our condition is sigma is approximately 0, or this part will become 0, so again this will become 1 only, and you will have only root of mu by epsilon as the magnitude part, right? Root of mu by epsilon as the magnitude part. And what will be the angle? If you see the angle, it is what? Tan 2 theta n equal to sigma by omega epsilon, right? Tan 2 theta n equal to tan 2 theta n equal to sigma by omega epsilon, right? So what is sigma? Sigma is 0, so this term tan 2 theta n will become equal to 0, right? Tan 2 theta n will become equal to 0 when tan theta will be 0. Tan theta will be 0 for theta equal to 0, so 2 theta n will be 0, or theta n also will be 0, right? So this is another interesting thing. In your intrinsic impedance, the value of magnitude is what? Root of mu by epsilon, and the angle is 0 degree. That is another observation here. So what does it mean? It means that when you take electric field and magnetic field, H means what? H equal to H will come what? H is what? E divided by eta. So and there will be a term in omega t minus beta z minus theta n, right? I think you remember. So here, since the magnitude of the the angle of the intrinsic impedance is 0 degree, your electric and magnetic field E and H, they will be in what? Phase. There will not be any phase difference between electric and magnetic field. That is the important observation here. Okay, so when you consider a plane wave or the electromagnetic wave propagation in lossless dielectric, you have two things here. What is the first thing? Your alpha is 0, right? Your alpha is 0, or there is no attenuation happening in a lossless dielectric. And the second part is that your beta value, the magnitude of eta, the angle of eta is also what? Equal to 0. That means that your electric and magnetic field vectors, they are in time phase with each other. Okay, so these are the two observations. So now let us see the electromagnetic wave propagation in free space. In free space, what are the conditions? Your conductivity is zero, your permittivity is epsilon zero, and mu is mu zero, right? This is quite similar to your lossless dielectric, except that epsilon and mu value are having a particular value, epsilon zero and mu zero. So here also what we will do, we will apply the same thing like alpha and beta we have here. So you think for yourself that what will happen? Nothing much is going to happen. Since conductivity is zero, this term again will become zero, right? Because of that, what will be your alpha value? Your alpha value will be equal to zero. And it is just similar to the case for lossless dielectric. When you apply for beta, this will become this will become zero. So total this term 1 plus 1, it will become, so it will be 2, and that 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So you will have omega root mu epsilon. In this particular case, what is your mu? Mu is the permittivity. Mu is what, the permeability of free space, and epsilon zero is the permittivity of free space, right? These values we already know, what mu zero, epsilon zero. Mu zero is given by what? 4 pi × 10⁻⁷ and farad per meter, and epsilon, Henry per meter, and epsilon zero is what? 8.85 × 10⁻¹². So if you calculate that value, we already have seen in one or two lecture before also, 1 by √√ μ0ε0 is equal to 3 × 10⁸, right? That is the velocity of electromagnetic wave in free space. That once we already derived. So this omega root mu zero epsilon zero is equal to what? Omega by c. So that is alpha is given by omega by c. This beta is given by what? Beta, the phase constant, is given by omega by c. The alpha is zero in free space also because you have zero conductivity. There is no attenuation. That is what we expect. And your beta value is equal to omega by c. Okay. So there is no attenuation of electromagnetic wave in a lossless dielectric. So free space also is similar. So here also you don't have any attenuation. The another part is what the wave velocity. Velocity is what? U equal to omega by beta. Again omega divided by beta is what? Beta is omega root mu epsilon. In this case, mu, it is mu zero epsilon zero. Your omega and omega will get cancelled. So what you will have? You will have 1 by √ μ0ε0. If you can try in calculator, if you give the value for mu zero and epsilon zero, you will get that 1 by √ μ0ε0 is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Which what is that? That is the velocity of light in vacuum, right? And the wavelength is given by 2 pi/beta. So it's non zero. So this is the velocity of light at vacuum. So what we can say here is that, or our understanding can be made like this. Like light is also an electromagnetic wave. In light also you have both electric as well as magnetic field. Light also is what? Electromagnetic wave. Light is also electromagnetic wave. Okay, so that is why that is what we can understand from here. For the free space, let us see intrinsic impedance, right? That will tell us what is the relationship between electric field and the magnetic field. So this is the magnitude in for general case. In this case, it is quite the same way, right? So the magnitude will be the same way. Why it is the same way? Because why it is in the same way? Because sigma by omega epsilon again will become zero, so that it will become root of mu by epsilon only. So in this case, it is mu zero by epsilon zero, right? Because we know the permeability and permittivity of the material, and the angle is just similar to the case of what? Lossless dielectric. But this value magnitude is something fixed when it comes to free space. That means we already know that. But if we apply the value for mu zero and epsilon zero, we will get eta as what? 120 pi. Okay, it will be given by 120 pi, or it will be equal to 377 ohm. This is the intrinsic impedance in free space. You can see that this intrinsic impedance unit is also ohm. So this is the intrinsic impedance in free space. Okay. Now, another thing here is that again, electric and magnetic field are in time phase with each other in free space. Your beta, your angular value is what? Zero again. So This is the two things you should understand understand in free space also. Okay, there is not much major difference. Once you know the lossless dielectric case, it is easy to extrapolate it into what the condition for free space. You just get some value, particular value. That much only is the difference. Let us see the wave more in more particular. Okay, so if how we get electric field, how we represent electric field. Electric field is given by E zero cos omega t minus beta z into a x square, and h is given by what? H zero cos omega t minus beta z, right? And minus theta also is there. In this particular case, h zero is given by what? E zero divided by eta, right? This we discussed in the last class. E zero divided by eta. That eta value is root of mu by epsilon and angle is zero. So because of the angle eta, intrinsic impedance the angular value is zero. Because of that, your electric and magnetic field vectors, they will be in phase. Means what? This is your electric field vector. Whenever this peak is happening at this point, same time magnetic field or peak is happening in the y direction. That is what we mean by electric and magnetic field are not out of phase, or they are in phase. Okay, and here in this particular diagram, we are considering the condition for time t equal to zero. When t equal to zero, then what we'll have in your omega t will become zero. That is why you only have this minus beta z term here. So with respect to the z only, we are plotting here. You can see that your electric field is considered to be varying in which direction? It is in the x direction. Your magnetic field is varying in the y direction, right? Your magnetic field is varying in the y direction. So this is the x direction is the direction of what? Electric field. Y direction is the direction of propagation of magnetic field. Then this AK means the direct wave propagation direction. AK is a general term that we will use for the wave propagation direction. So in general, let the unit vectors for the direction of electric field, magnetic field, and direction of wave propagation as A E cap, A S cap, and A K cap. Okay, here A E cap means what? The x direction. A S cap means the y direction, and A K cap is the z direction. So if we take what is A X cross A Y, it is A Z, right? A X cross A Y is equal to A Z. A Y cross A Z equal to A X, right? This we already learned in our first lecture. So AE cross AS means the unit vectors in the direction of what? Electric field and the magnetic field. If we take their cross product, what we will have? We will have the direction of propagation of the wave. Okay, this you may keep in mind, because this is something we will be interested in the next lecture. Clear? So that is the direction of propagation of the wave. So means what? Your electric field is a function of what? Electric field is a function of z as well as p, and your magnetic field also is a function of z as well as p, but they are varying in which direction? Electric field in the x direction and magnetic field in the y direction. Okay, propagation direction will be perpendicular to both this axis. Okay, the same thing is shown here in this plot, where what we are making here constant. Here your z is constant. Okay, at a particular plane, at a particular xy plane where your z is constant, okay, z is some value k, at that point you are seeing electric field, what? E equal to e zero cos omega t a x cap, and h equal to h zero cos omega t a y cap. Okay, one in a electric field in this direction and magnetic field along this y direction. Okay, at every point you will have the same magnitude here, because they are in phase. They are in phase with respect to time. Okay. So both E and H field are everywhere normal to the direction of wave propagation. Right. This is one point we should understand when it comes to electromagnetic wave propagation. Now let me a bit more definition here. In this figure you can see that the fields lie in a plane that is transverse or orthogonal to the direction of wave propagation. Right. Your Z is the direction of wave propagation. And in which all direction electric field is there? Electric field is only there in the x direction. Magnetic field will be only there in the y direction. Means which are 90 degree orthogonal to the direction of the wave propagation. Such waves are what we call as what? The transverse waves. And here, since it is electromagnetic wave, we call as transverse electromagnetic or TEM, transverse electromagnetic wave or TEM wave. Okay, transverse electromagnetic wave. That is the kind of wave this year. So I think now you are understand what is meant by transverse. Now, a combination of VA and H is called uniform plane wave. Okay, this is what is meant by the uniform plane wave, because E or H will have the same magnitude throughout any transverse plane for Z equal to constant. As you can see here, E and H, if you take any transverse plane, like this is at Z equal to 1, another plane you consider in space at Z equal to 2. Again, you will get what E and H will be the same along one plane. So that is what is meant by uniform plane wave. Now I believe you got an understanding of what is meant by uniform plane wave. Means your wave is varying in a particular plane. Okay, that is what is meant by uniform plane wave. The electric field only in the x direction, the magnetic field only in the y direction. Now, one more thing, one theoretical concept here is that your alpha value is zero in a lossless dielectric or free space, right? So when your alpha is what? Alpha means attenuation. Attenuation constant is zero, means there is no attenuation of wave. It is like saying that your electric or magnetic field, this electromagnetic wave, it is not having a start as well as there is no end also for this particular wave. Okay, that also indicates, means it will be over at infinity. So that also indicates that it is of infinite energy. But that is not the reality. Okay, that is not the reality. So this this condition serves as an approximation to the practical waves. Basically, anyhow, after some time it will attenuate. Okay, so that is not a reality. With this, we completed lossless dielectric and free space. Now let us see what happens for plane waves in good conductors. Okay, what is the condition for good conductor? Good conductor means your conductivity is somewhat very high up to infinity. Like we can assume it to be comparatively infinity, and your permittivity is epsilon zero and your permeability mu equal to mu zero. Okay, so this is what good conductor is. Okay, not frankly mu is not mu zero, it is mu zero mu r. Now if you see, apply that thing here, your conductivity is becoming infinity. Okay, your conductivity is becoming infinity. Or I can say that when my conductivity is become infinity, this sigma by omega epsilon, that term will be comparatively very much higher than 1. Right? Your conductivity is such a high value, so that your sigma by omega epsilon is somewhat comparatively very much higher than 1. So when we apply that in the alpha term first here, this is a general term, right, for a lossy dielectric. So in this alpha, if we apply, sigma by omega epsilon is comparatively very much compared to this one. So 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon all square is again what? Sigma by omega epsilon all square. So if you take root of that, it will become sigma by omega epsilon. So sigma by omega epsilon is, that sigma by omega epsilon is what? Very much greater than 1. So even if you reduce this minus from there, nothing is going to happen. Right? Even if you reduce minus 1 from, nothing is going to happen. So yeah, here it is clearly written. So your is alpha equal to omega root of mu 0 mu r epsilon 0 by 2. This is your equation, right? It is not mu 0 alone, it is mu 0 mu r. It can have permeability. A conductor can have permeability. So if you do apply that here, so what you will have, the sigma by omega epsilon 0 all square plus 1. This whole term will become sigma by omega epsilon 0 all square first. Then if you again reduce my 1 from that, again it will become what? This sigma by omega epsilon 0. Because the sigma by omega epsilon 0 is very much higher value compared to your 1. So if whether you deduct one or whether you add 1, there will not be much difference in the value. Now in this equation, you can cut off what? Epsilon 0 and epsilon 0 on this side. Right? So this will become... this will become what? And there is one omega here, right? So if you take in this omega inside to the root, what will happen? If you take omega inside the root, it will become omega square, and you have to cut off one omega here, and one omega will be left in the numerator. You can try this in your book. Okay, so one omega will be left here, so the whole equation will become what? Omega mu sigma divided by 2. Again here you have mu 0 mu r. Okay, I'm sorry about that. So omega mu sigma by 2. Okay, now what is the omega value? Omega is given by 2 pi f. So that 2 and this 2 get cancelled and you get the equation for alpha. Alpha is what? Root of pi f mu sigma. This is very important. So in a good conductor, since it has conductivity, definitely your electromagnetic wave is having attenuation or there is power loss. Okay, there is electromagnetic wave is having attenuation. Its value is equal to pi f mu sigma. So on what all quantities it is depending on? It depends mainly on the frequency, right? And it also depends on conductivity and permeability. Okay, mainly on, let me say mainly on frequency. And if we apply the same concept here on beta, again what will happen? Sigma by omega epsilon all square plus 1, that is sigma by omega epsilon all square only. With that, if you add plus 1 again, there is not much difference. Again, you will get the same equation here. So your alpha and beta, your alpha and beta will be same for a good conductor, which is equal to root of pi f mu sigma. Now, that means it is having attenuation and there is a phase constant. Now, what is the intrinsic impedance? We will apply the same here. If we see here, this is our intrinsic impedance magnitude, right? So in this case, we will apply what? This sigma by omega epsilon 0 or square is quite higher compared to 1. So again, this will become, all square will become what? Sigma by omega epsilon 0 after this, this is 1 by 4. So this is root of sigma by omega epsilon 0. Here we will cut down this epsilon 0, right? And when it goes to the numerator, what you will have? This will be root of mu by epsilon 0 divided by sigma, right? So this will become root of omega mu by sigma. You can see the derivation if you want. Okay, this is just cutting out epsilon 0 and this should go to the this side. Okay, so you will get root of omega mu divided by sigma. That is the magnitude of eta. Now, what about the angle of eta? Tan 2 theta is given by sigma by omega epsilon 0. And sigma is what? Sigma is infinity, somewhat very much higher. So your tan 2 theta n is going to become what? Tan 2 theta n will become, it will be quite high, like infinity. Then you can say when tan theta will be infinite at theta equal to 90 degree. So your theta n will be what? 90 divided by 2 or theta, the magnitude will be 45 degree. Okay. So in a good conductor, you know how much will be the value, the shift in what? The shift in magnetic field compared to electric field. That is 45 degree. Okay. So your electric field. So that is what is meant, right? Electric field, if it is E0 cos omega t minus beta z, then your magnetic field will be what? E0 divided by root of omega mu by sigma. That will become the magnitude of what? H0. H0 will be E0 divided by root of omega mu by sigma into cos of omega t minus beta z minus 45. So that minus 45 will come there. So we can say the electric field will lead the magnetic field by how much degree? 45 degrees. Electric field will lead magnetic field by 45 degree in a good conductor. Okay. And there will be attenuation as well. Now, so this particular eta here is defined as the surface impedance of a good conductor. It is defined as the surface impedance of a good conductor. Okay, let us see a bit more. Like electric field is given by like what? E0 e raised to minus alpha z. Because here your alpha is not 0, you have an alpha. You have an attenuation. Cos omega t minus beta z. This is our reference. Okay, now what is your magnetic field? Magnetic field is given by E0 by root of omega mu by sigma e raised to minus alpha z cos omega t minus beta z minus 45 degree. So there will be a electric field will be leading or magnetic field is lagging the electric field. Okay. So this is the, now this attenuation, from this attenuation we are going to define something here. Like E or H is attenuated in a conducting medium. That is known for sure. Your electric field as well as magnetic field is attenuated in a conducting medium. Right. So how much it is getting attenuated is seen here. So this distance 0.368 means e raised to minus 1 or 1 by e. Okay. So that much is 0.368 E0. So first it was E0 and at a distance delta, right? This is the direction of propagation inside the conductor. So inside the conductor, while passing through the conductor after a distance delta, it attenuates to how much? E power minus 1 value. That particular value we call as delta. Or this term is something this term is familiar to you. So in delta distance, the amplitude decreases to a factor of what? E power minus 1. We can represent it like this. Like this is what E0 e raised to minus alpha delta is the attenuation envelop the, so it is equal to E0 e raised to minus 1, right? At z equal to delta, whenever your z value is delta, it is equal to e power minus 1, or minus alpha delta equal to what? Minus 1, or alpha delta equal to 1. From that we can say the delta is equal to 1 by alpha. Okay, so this delta is what we call as skin depth. This is called as skin depth. Means when your electromagnetic field is propagating through a conductor, what happens in the conductor, it can propagate on the skin, right? From the conductor, when it is passing through the conductor, then by the time it reaches delta distance, by the kind of time it reaches the skin depth, the magnitude of wave will be attenuated by how much? 1 by E, or 36 point, it will become what? 37% of the original value, 36.8% of the original value. This particular distance is what we call as the skin depth. Okay, it is a depth to which an electromagnetic wave can penetrate the medium. Afterwards, the value is quite slow or negligible. So it is a depth to up to which the electromagnetic wave can penetrate the medium, which is called as skin depth. That is equal, delta is given by 1 by alpha. 1 by attenuation constant is what? This is when we are talking about good conductor. Okay, so delta is 1 by alpha. We have already defined alpha. Alpha is what? Pi f, root of pi f mu sigma. So delta is equal to root of 1 by pi f mu sigma. From here itself we can say that whenever your frequency value is increasing, what will happen to delta? When your frequency is increasing, your skin depth will decrease. Skin depth will decrease means that much less your conducting medium can be penetrated when electromagnetic wave is traveling. Understood? Skin depth is less, meant that much lesser it is. Now in this, for a just to take what, just take a pi f, root of pi f mu to one side, then what you will get, if you take the root of pi f mu from this part to one side, what you will get? You will get 1 by delta root sigma, right? Now what, let us see intrinsic impedance again. Intrinsic impedance, what it means, what intrinsic impedance here is what? Root of omega mu by sigma, right? So in this equation, omega we can substitute as 2 pi f, so it will become 2 pi f mu divided by sigma, right? 2 pi f mu divided by sigma. So in here, this for this root of pi f mu, we can apply what, our this equation, which is 1 by delta root sigma. So it will become root 2 divided by delta root sigma into sigma. So the sigma, root of sigma and sigma will become sigma, and delta will be, so this will become 1 by sigma delta root into root 2, right? And if we consider sigma as a complex number, this is the magnitude, and what is the angular part? It is pi by 4, right? 45 degrees. So that is why I am written it in e raised to j pi by 4. This in complex term can be written as 1 plus j divided by sigma delta. Okay, you can just apply cos pi by 4 plus j sine pi by 4. That is how you get this 1 plus j divided by sigma delta. Okay, into root 2 will be there. So with that you will get this thing. Okay, root 2 into cos pi by 4 plus j sine pi by 4 will give you this 1 plus j divided by sigma delta, which is your intrinsic impedance. Okay, it is having a real value and imaginary value, right? So this is intrinsic impedance. Now how can we represent our electric field? Electric field can also be represented this way, like electric field E is equal to E0 e raised to minus alpha z. So alpha is what? 1 by delta, or delta is 1 by alpha. That if we take here, what usually it is e raised to minus alpha z, it can be taken as e raised to minus z by delta also. Now cos omega t minus beta z, there also beta is also 1 by delta. So that also can be applied here. Okay, so this can be related in terms of delta also, electric field. So delta measures the damping of electromagnetic wave, right? So here delta, this part measures the damping of electromagnetic wave as it travels through the conductor, right? How much it is getting attenuated, that is what is meant by delta in a delta, or the skin depth in electromagnetic. Now skin depth is given like this, and for a particular conductor like copper, okay, copper, if you apply copper conductivity here, conductivity, copper is having some conductivity value, and I just varied the frequency, okay, this is plotted in MATLAB. So I just varied the frequency from 10 power 1 means 10 to 10 power 6 means what, 1 megahertz. Okay, So if I vary the frequency, you can see here, the skin depth is given in millimeter here. Okay, the skin depth is given in millimeter. Here, you can see here that the how much depth it can have. From 10 hertz to 10 power 6 hertz, it is just exponentially decreasing. Your skin depth is exponentially decreasing. So when you come to some, this is 100 hertz. So at some 50 hertz, it will have some skin depth. Okay. It will be having some skin depth, but when you are going to higher frequency, what will happen? As you go to higher and higher frequencies, then your skin depth is comparatively very less. Very less means very less. Like this is what 5 into 10 power minus 6, or in micrometer range of what skin depth means. That or if you consider a conductor here. What is happening, a conductor is having a radius of a, so only in the small cylindrical ring, only in the small circular ring, that is the part where your whole electromagnetic wave is propagating. Inside the whole medium, there is no electromagnetic wave propagation. Understood? Most of the energy is traveling through outside the conductor. Okay. A similar thing you already encountered in your power system analysis or power systems also, that on your conductor, the skin effect, right? Skin effect is nothing new to you. So this is the phenomenon whereby your field density in a conductor rapidly decreases in a conductor. Okay, this is the whereby the field density in a conductor rapidly decreases. So that effect is what is called as skin effect. Skin effect is when your field density in a conductor is rapidly decreasing. So what happens because of that? Because of that, your electromagnetic wave is mostly propagating, or whether it is your current or your charge, whatever it is mostly where it is existing. It is existing on the surface, right? It is existing on the surface, as you can see here. So the charges migrate from the bulk of the conductor to the surface, right? So the current is passing through only which area, or a very smaller cross-sectional area on that circular ring. So what does it indicate? It indicates that you will have higher resistance. That is why we say your AC resistance is higher than DC resistance, right? For the same conductor, if you pass DC and AC, with AC your resistance will be higher, and with DC your resistance will be lower. Right, because AC means what? Higher frequency. Now, the skin depth will decrease with the increase in frequency, as you have seen in the last slide. So, what are the applications of this? One application, as I said, is what? AC resistance of transmission line. Okay, while doing electrical machines or any other thing, you might have seen that you usually multiply your DC resistance or whatever resistance you measured with a galvanometer where you apply a DC with some constant to apply it into your AC circuit. So that there your resistance will increase for an AC resistance. And the second application, electromagnetic shielding. Electromagnetic shielding is like, let me say you have a conductor like this. Okay, let me say you have a as per this figure, you have something like this, and you want to shield something inside this. Okay, so in electromagnetic shielding, if you have a higher conductivity material on the surface, then your wave will be able to propagate only to some extent only. Understood? If you want from higher frequency, if you want to shield something, your wave will not be able to propagate to a higher distance inside. That is what we apply in electromagnetic shielding also. There we usually use, for electromagnetic shield, we use very high conductivity material. Means whenever your conductivity increases, again your skin depth will be decreasing, right? So that other one, two, that's about skin effect. Now AC resistance, if we see, what is the DC resistance? It is given by L by sigma x, right? Or rho L by s, rho L by s, right? Where s is what? S is the area of cross section and L is the length. Now, we already defined surface resistance. Surface resistance means what? Surface resistance is the real part of sigma. Okay, I wrote it as 1 plus j divided by root sigma, sigma delta. So what is real part of j? Real part of what? Real part of eta. Real part of eta is what we call as surface resistance. That is equal to 1 by sigma delta. Now, if we compare these two equations, you can understand quite easily one thing. This 1 by sigma delta, 1 by sigma delta means what? It represents, 1 by sigma delta represents the resistance of a unit length and unit width of the conductor. Right? If L, if we give the value of 1, that is what here, and width is means what? This width is means what? Width of the, not width will be what? 1, okay, 1 into delta. So that is what is represented by the surface resistance. Okay. This derivation you can see, delta we already know is 1 by root of pi f mu sigma. So with that we get it as what? Pi, root of pi f mu divided by sigma. Now that is for the, that is for this one. Now for a known length of L and width W, if we consider, RAC is given by what? L divided by sigma delta into W. So this L divided by sigma delta, L divided by sigma delta is what? That is what is surface resistance, right? So this will be equal to RS into L divided by, this is the general case of AC resistance. Now for a for this conductor of what? Circular cross section, let me say your skin depth. Your skin depth is delta. So what will be the area through which your wave is propagating? That will be delta into W, where W is the width, right? For a conductor of radius A, what will be the width? Width means what? Whatever be the circumference of this area, right? So that width will be equal to 2 pi A. Correct? Width will be equal to 2 pi A. 2 pi A into delta will give you the blue area in this figure through which your wave is propagating, right? So your RAC by RDC I can represent like this. L divided, L is the length of the conductor, RAC divided by sigma into 2 pi a delta will give you the surface area. So whenever it is AC, your wave is propagating. And when you compare DC, what happens? L divided by sigma a. Here area cross section is the complete conductor, which is equal to pi a square. Right. So if you do this, and you can after going through this, you will get what is the equation. The RAC by RDC is given by a by 2 delta, or it is equal to a by 2 into root of pi f mu delta. Or from this you can very easily see that whenever your frequency is increasing, whenever your frequency is increasing, so this is not delta, this is sigma, I am really sorry. So whenever your frequency is increasing, what will happen? Your AC resistance will be higher, or RAC by RDC will be greater than 1, right? So whenever it is DC, then your RAC by RDC value will be 1. It, as frequency increases, your RAC by RDC value also will increase. Okay. So when your frequency is increasing, what will happen? Your skin depth will decrease. Skin depth decreases means most of the wave is propagating to the surface. Right. So it is having lesser cross section for the wave to pass through. That is why your resistance, RAC by RDC value, will be very much greater than 1. When your frequency is very much high, your skin depth will be very much less, and what? Your resistance is comparatively, AC resistance of the conductor is comparatively very much high compared to DC value. That is when your wave is really propagating through, let me say, out, most of the energy is going on through the surface, or it is mostly it is going through the surface, not through inside the conductor. Okay, that is when your frequency is quite high. So this is about electromagnetic wave propagation. We discussed the four cases through a lossy dielectric, lossless dielectric, through free space, as well as in conductor in this lecture. Now in the next lecture, you will see polarization of electromagnetic wave and Poynting's theorem. Okay. So please answer the assignment given in Google Classroom by the end of this day. Thank you.